February, you know, as you all know, is the month of love. Although, you know, we are meant to show love every day of our lives, you know. Praise God. Love is a daily thing. Love is not something seasonal, you know. Love is not something that should be done once a month in a year, you know. We should always try to show ourselves love. Try to show your neighbors love. Praise God. Praise the name of God. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Okay, our topic, our theme for this month is inspiring love. Praise God. Can someone echo it? Inspiring love.
Inspiring love.
Inspiring love. I was greatly blessed last week by our mommy, Omititi Adebele. She, you know, made certain points. She explained what inspiring love is. She gave us the types of love. The Bible, she said the Bible, okay, like I'll just do like a 2 minute recap of the things she said. For those of us that missed it. She said the Bible definition of love is deep and profound. It's beyond what excites you, you know, beyond all the, should I say, the love in the air thing and then the feelings you feel about. Love goes beyond all those. Praise God. The real love thinks about other persons. So, beyond just yourself, genuine love considers other people's well-being also. It teams up another person. Jesus' kind of love is unconditional. A lot of love we see on Valentine's Day is conditional. You know, most ladies, I'm sorry for using the ladies, you know, they expect, they are always expectant, you know, Valentine's Day is coming and they are expectant of a gift or something from the person they are in a relationship with. They neglect the fact that they are also meant to, you know, show love to the person by giving something. Praise God. Praise the name of Jesus. Am I lying?
No,
you're
not.
Yeah. Okay. She gave the type of love that we have. I'm sure we all know these things. Eros love, filial love, storge love, and then the agape love, which is the most truest form of love. Praise God. Praise the name of Jesus. Okay. Today's topic is inspired to love. I just kind of, repackaged the topic. Inspire to love. Tell them what inspire to love.
Inspire.
You can't inspire love if you yourself are not inspired enough. Praise God. You can't inspire love if you are not inspired. And what does it mean to be inspired or to inspire? Number one is to heighten or intensify. Two says, to serve as the insisting cause of something, to spur or encourage. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. It means to motivate, to influence, to arouse, to fire up, to enkindle. Praise God. Meaning that if you want to inspire love, you need to be motivated enough within you. That there's a law in there's a principle in law. Nemo called Don Abe that says you can't give what you don't have. Meaning, if you want to inspire love, you need to be inspired well enough. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. There are some people, they don't love themselves. It is really saddening. Some people don't love themselves. So how do such people show love to others? Please let's open our books, our Bible, to the book of Mark 12:30. We will be reading together. Mark 12:30. Okay. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. Okay, verse 31, please. And the second is like namely this: thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. If you want to love thy neighbor, you need to first of all love yourself, right? There is no other commandment greater than this. Okay, verse 32. Okay. Yeah, so we need to first of all show ourselves love before we can show others love. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. The proof that we love genuinely is by showing ourselves love. We read the book of 1 John 4 that said, how can you claim to love God when people you can see, you don't even show them enough love? Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. And if I pass the microphone now and then I tell everyone to, okay, just give me a brief definition of love or what love means to you, I'm sure we all have one or two things to say about love. I'm sure by now we know that love goes beyond, you know, that feeling, affection. Love is more. Love to me is not a noun, it's a verb. Love is what you do, you know. Anyone can say, I love you. Talk is very cheap. Like, anyone can claim to love you, but if there's no commensurate action to back it up, then that love is not genuine. Praise God. Amen. Praise the living Jesus. Amen. Okay, the next slide, please. Okay, so I said here, what is true love really? What is true love? I said, one, the beginning of every true love is the knowledge of God. Let's read 1 John 4, verse 7 to 8. Meaning, if you don't know God, there's no way you can really show true love. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. Is projected on message part, please. Message version. I think I prefer that. Okay. My beloved friends, let us continue to love each other, since love comes from God. Anyone who loves is born of God and experiences a relationship with God. Verse 8, please. Next one. The person who refuses to love doesn't know the first thing about God, because God is love. So you can't know Him if you don't love. So the truest form of love, or the truest evidence that you are showing love, is first having a relationship with God. Because He showed us the perfect example of love. He showed us just the exact thing called love. He Himself is called love. So if you want to really be inspired to love, you need to first of all have a connect with God. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Okay, back to the slide, please. True love is giving and sacrificial. You can give without loving, or you can't love without giving. You know, you can give without loving, but you can't love. There's no way you will say, okay, I love this person, I love that person, without, you know, sacrificing certain things, your time, affection, even money. Most times it's necessary. I'm not saying it's bad to give gifts on Vows Day. Well, it's a good thing. You are just emulating our Father. Because according to the book of John 3:16, He gave His own and only begotten Son just for our sake. Please let's read 1 John 4:9. 1 John chapter 4, verse 9. We are not opening our Bibles. Please let's open our Bibles. In fact, I want someone from the audience to read from the congregation. Please let's pass the second one. 1 John chapter 4, verse 9.
In this was manifested the love of God towards us, because that God sent His only begotten Son into the world that we might live through Him.
God sent His his one and only begotten son that we might live through him. So God showed us that example that, okay, if you want to love, first thing, you must give. If you claim to love me, I should see it by your giving. I should see it by certain sacrifices you render. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Okay, what is true love, really? If you read the book of 1 Corinthians 13, we see some attributes of love. Love is kind. Love is not puffed up. Love is not proud. Okay, please let's read. Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels and have not charity, please, can you project the New King Version? New King Version. Okay. Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I have become sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. Okay, next verse. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am still nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though giving is good, but if it's not with the right motive. You know, so many people out there in the world have bastardized the word called love. Most people see love as so many things. So many things. So now some people eat kissing, romance, smooshing, all those things is not involved. There is no love to them. It's something else. Until those things are involved, then now you are speaking their language. And though I be so all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but I have not love, it profits me nothing. Next one. Love suffers long and is kind. Praise God. So, love tolerates. Love covers a multitude of sin. Love is patient. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. Love is not puffed up. Next one, please. Does not behave rudely, does not seek it. So, you know, we know these things, but it's so funny that we really don't know these things. May God help us in Jesus' name. Love is not provoked, thinks no evil. Next one, does not rejoice in iniquity. Love is not that thing that when you see, okay, let's assume you are in a class and then you see someone as a threat, maybe you are on 3 points. 4.79 and the person is on 4.8 something, you know, just way above you, and maybe one led to another and the person just drops or something. Love is not that thing that would be so happy, yes. And now love will go to that person, ask what happened exactly, what really happened, how did you miss it, you know. We try to bring that person back on track. Love does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. What is the truth exactly? You know, I was in GST class on Tuesday, and the man does philosophy and logic. The man, like, we're not saying all sorts of things that there's nothing like truth. In philosophy, there's no truth. So, you know, in my mind, I was thinking of so many things. I asked him some questions. I was like, okay, but sir, you are a male. He said no. That's not the truth. It's also confusing, but you know, I believe because I was scared to face God. Believe all things, believe all things, hopes all things, endures all things. The truth, as we know it, according to the Bible, is who? Is who? It's Jesus. Praise God. Love never fails, but whether they are prophecies, they will fail. Whether they are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish. So if you just say that, please, that's previous. Knowledge is good. Prophecy is good. It is good to speak in tongues. If it is not centered around love, it is in vain. We go to the person just in.
Amen.
Okay, next one, please. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. Okay? But when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part will be done away. Okay, next one. When I was a child, next one, please. For now, okay, next one. And now abide faith, hope, and love. These three. But the greatest of this is. But the greatest of this is love. Praise God. You can't claim to love if you don't know the origin of love. That's the source of love. You can't love if you don't know the source of love. Praise God. He that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him. That can be found in the book of 1 John 4. Let's project verse 18. 1 John 4, 18. And we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love, and he who abides in love abides in God, and God in him. So when we portray the true kind of love, we are abiding in God, and God is abiding, is living in us. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Now, sometimes it can be awful when you love, you are showing true love, and you are being treated, you know, in a harsh manner. It can happen. Jesus said we should love those who treat us unfairly. You know, like it can be so hard, but there are sometimes when you really care about someone and the person is just doing anyhow, it must love someone and not be loved. That is even the time when you should love the more. Praise God. Because while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So even when we were so unlovable, he was still showing us love. We should try to emulate this. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ. Giving someone all your love is never an assurance that they will love you back. Don't expect love in return. Just wait for it to grow in their heart. The best you can do is to pray. Is to pray. Holy Spirit, you know, can impart in them the fruit of love. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Just wait for it to grow in their hearts, but if it doesn't, be content that it grew in yours. Praise God. Praise God. Okay, the next. Okay. The truest measure of God's love is that he loves us without measure. The truest measure of God's love is that he loves us without measure. You know, God loves us so much that even in our fallen state, he still wants to bring us back. We know the story of this guy that took his father's property and went away, lavished it, he spent it so badly that he was feeding on swine's and food. But even despite all those, he came back to his senses and went to his father. His father still received him back. That's the truest measure of God's love for us. Now, what love is not? I've said it, love goes beyond just, you know, feelings, affections, all those kind of things. Love is more of a responsibility. It is an action. Praise God. Love goes beyond sex and romance. Sex and romance should be for those in marriage. Yes, as we all know it. Let's read Colossians 3:5. So as youths, we are meant to put our body under. We are meant to mortify. You know. Okay. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is idolatry. We are meant to put our body under. May God help us in Jesus' name. May God help us in Jesus' name. Love is not fear. Fear has torment. According to book of 1 John 4:18. Fear has torment, but perfect love casteth out fear. When you are filled with love, I doubt if you'll be afraid of anything. Of course, the only person you are meant to be fearful of is God. But I'm not talking of that kind of fear. I mean fear in a negative sense. You know. So perfect love casts out fear. Now, what have I been saying since morning? Love is of God. God is the source of love. If you truly want to be inspired, or you want to inspire love, you need to first of all have a relationship with God. Praise God. If you want to be encouraged or be inspired to love, first and first, a relationship with God. Praise God. Please let's bow our heads. Is there anyone here that wants to say, okay, I've heard this talk, I've heard this message, and I want to begin a walk with Jesus this morning. I want to start a walk with God, because without that, everything else is just a show, a jamboree. Praise God. Is there anyone here that wants to say, I want to start a walk with God this morning? I want to start a relationship with God. Just raise up your hands as I pray with you. Is there anyone that wants to start a walk or a relationship with God? Is there anyone that wants to connect with the source of love? Anyone? Heavenly Father, we thank you. Thank you for speaking these words to us. Thank you for ministering to us once again. Father, please take all the glory in the name of Jesus. In any way we've not been showing love the right way, Father, please have mercy upon us in Jesus' name and show us the right path to show love in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the love you have for us, Father, for your word to be praised.